We're here with Jeremy Hoop. Jeremy, tell us a little bit about what went on tonight.
We're here because of Endorsed Liberty, one of the largest super PACs in the country, political action committees that happens to support Ron Paul and the broader cause of liberty. And tonight we held an event to, there were probably 400 to 500 people here to help.
That was pretty impressive, actually.
Thank you. To help educate them on specific things they can do, not just to help us as a PAC and help the Ron Paul campaign specifically, but what they can do to get involved in the political process and help affect the outcome of the election.
Yeah, we were talking just a minute ago before we got on camera here about how I was telling you about the ignorant arrogance factor. I actually feel like we're all just a bunch of ignorant people out there, and it people take that wrong. Ignorance is a kind of a bad word in our society, but we're ignorant, and it's I'm one of them. I still feel very ignorant to a lot of political processes, the issues, all these different things, but I felt prompted and very inspired the last year, especially the last 3 or 4 months, to get involved. And the more I was a Romney supporter up front, and the more I learned, the more I realized I wanted to support truth. And Ron Paul was the epitome of truth and consistency and fundamental values that we need to protect and bring ourselves back to the Constitution and the original founding fathers' message. What do you say to that? I mean, do you agree to that, or is that why you support Ron Paul?
Absolutely. I started studying the Constitution in 1993 when my mom said, after I came home from living abroad for a couple of years, and she said, you have to start reading certain books. So she gave me a whole library to read, and I became...
you did it.
A devotee of the founders and their philosophy and the idea of limited government and individual responsibility and inalienable rights that come from God, not from our government, and the separation of powers, et cetera, et cetera. A Republican form of government, not democracy, not socialism. And I'm a big believer that, like you said, that when they learn why America was founded, when they learn where their rights come from, when they understand the basic principles of the Constitution, it resonates with them because it informs their experience, the prosperity that we've experienced to a degree. It can be argued that some of the prosperity we've experienced is, in fact, of late, is all based on a lie, based on debt, and based on an organization that's corrupt, the Federal Reserve. But when they learn about the fundamental principles that founded the country, they tend to begin to wake up and understand that all of the politicians, but a very few, and most of the businesses today, and most of the organizations that have control and sway in the country, have abandoned the Constitution, and that the only solution is not to politic anymore, not to
play the game,
not to play the game and compromise principles, but it's actually to go back and stand on true principles, and as quickly as possible move back to those things,
and maybe learn for the first time ever in your existence the issues. How about that?
Well, absolutely. And there's a lot that has to be learned. Things like why it is that money has such an influence in the government. Well, because they've abandoned the Constitution with things like the 17th Amendment, which we don't have time to go into, but things like completely overstepping the 10th Amendment and doing away with state sovereignty and taking the government from the people in their localities and placing it in the hands of the federal government, which is exactly what the founders didn't want.
Well, do you feel like politicians themselves, probably the majority of them, don't know even most of the fundamental issues in the first place? I mean, I
wouldn't presume to know what they know or don't.
I will. I'll do it for you. I just don't feel like they know the issues. I really don't.
Well, I feel like some of them know, and some of them may not know. If they don't know, I'm very surprised. But if they don't know, then they are actively working against what the country was founded on, for a variety of reasons, for self-interest, for...
I guess that's why I assume that, because I can't... It's just kind of shock and awe to me when people don't support the fundamental nature of why the Constitution was
because once you are given power, power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts absolutely, and people want to protect their own territory. And when you're in the halls of Congress and you're treated like a little demigod or a little prince of Egypt, you have temptations that are hard to overcome.
That arrogance, maybe it's the whole thing
with the Tea Party. I was very active in the Tea Party, and I noticed that, you know, I think that most of the Tea Party people, my opinion is they support the Constitution so long as it doesn't touch their Social Security, or so long as it doesn't touch their benefits, you know. And
it's interesting.
And that's how it is with most Americans, unfortunately, because we've all been lulled asleep and we've all voted from the public coffers our own self-interest. And so we have to individually understand that we have to go back to the Constitution. We have to take government back in our own hands, which means taking responsibility back in our own hands. It's not just about this ethereal thing of liberty. Liberty means responsibility. Liberty means that I have to take care of you and you have to take care of your neighbor. And
activate
Well, we have to become a different kind of people. Mm-hmm. We have to understand that taking care of the poor, for example, this is the reason why the leftist argument resonates so well, because they think it's going to take care of the poor when in reality it does just the opposite. Mm-hmm. But it plays on people's heartstrings and makes them feel good. But the liberty argument says that we're all responsible for ourselves, but we're also individually responsible for each other. And that's what the founders understood.
But it's got to be the choice of the individual to...
Of course, can't be done by force.
Yeah, and a lot of stuff is done by force, and a lot of stuff is done by conditioning. And we've been conditioned by from the time you were born, before you were born, society and our communities have been conditioned by the media. I mean, that should be obvious to everybody. So if we know that much, we should have maybe a thirst or a desire to actually take it to the next level and become aware for the first time ever of some issues that are maybe causing the results that we're all complaining about. Would you agree with that?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We have to make hard choices. And by the way, we're going to be forced into those choices if we don't make them now. Because one of the reasons I support Ron Paul is people are talking about our country going away of Greece. Well, Ron Paul for a long time has been saying that we're going the way of Rome, ancient Rome, not Greece. And that's total destruction.
Yeah.
Not just a massive depression with violence in the streets. Total and complete destruction if we don't turn around. And so we'll be forced to, one way or another, we'll be forced to end our foreign adventures, propping up dictators, having 900 military bases in 150 countries. We'll be forced to reconcile our Social Security problem, our Medicare, Medicaid problem, over $100 trillion plus in unfunded liabilities that we have over the next 20 some odd years. Our escalating debt are currently nearly, between $15-16 trillion of debt. I mean, it's ridiculous. And only fools and drunkards would continue to prop this up. But unfortunately, there's a lot of people in the country who fit that definition, and especially in government.
I love the drunkard statement. I haven't heard that word in a long time.
Well, that's what we are. We're drunk on our own prosperity.
It's true. I agree with it. Yeah. Well, Jeremy, I really appreciate your time, man, and you did a great, great job putting this together.
Thank you.
And I love the videos. I'm going to actually put those videos up on the Exordium channel on YouTube, and we'll push these things all over the place because the message is great. The entertainment value is incredible. It'll give them a reason to share it. And if you're watching this, we hope that you guys take part in supporting the political process in general, and especially Ron Paul for the next president of the United States. So thanks for your time, Jeremy. Appreciate it.